In this video review, we will look into two questions. The first, besides the archaic hominins, Neanderthals and Denisovans, do we have indications of additional unknown archaic humanoids that intermingled with either them or anatomically modern humans? The second, it is known that all humans out of Africa carry Neanderthal DNA, but did it go the other way as well? Do some of their sequenced Neanderthals carry ancient anatomically modern human DNA remains? When anatomically modern human dispersed out of Africa to Eurasia, it is well known that they intermingled with the archaic humans living there. All out of African carry a couple of percent Neanderthal ancestry, and Eastern, Southeastern Asians and Australasians all in addition also carry Denisovan ancestry. In case of Australasians, up to 1/20th of their DNA. The Denisovan was discovered by DNA extraction from a phallax bone in the Denisova cave, and to date, besides a jawbone from Xiahe in China, this is the only remain of a Denisovan. So the question arises, given the huge amount of luck in discovering the Denisovan archaic hominin, were there perhaps more archaic hominins as well? The information here is from the paper The Complete Genome Sequence of a Neanderthal from the Altai Mountains in Nature, a treasure trove of information. The article is mainly about the sequence of the Neanderthal from Altai, but they also, in addition, do a lot of more analyses, including looking for an unknown archaic hominin. As the ancestors of both Neanderthals and Denisovans left Africa before the emergence of modern humans, one might expect present-day Africans to share equal proportions of the derived alleles with those two archaic groups. However, they find that African genomes share about 7% more derived alleles with the Neanderthal genome than with the Denisovan, and that this is particularly the case for derived alleles that are fixed in Africans, of which 13-16% more are shared with Neanderthals than with Denisovans. The authors tested three non-mutually exclusive scenarios that could explain these observations. First, gene flow from the ancestors of Neanderthals after the split from Denisovans into the ancestors of all present-day humans would result in a more sharing of derived alleles between present-day Africans and Neanderthals. However, because gene flow contributes alleles at low frequency, the sharing of derived alleles with Neanderthals would grow weaker with higher African-derived allele frequency, but the opposite is the case, which makes this unlikely. Second, gene flow from the ancestor of present-day humans to Neanderthals after the split from the Denisovans would also result in more sharing of derived alleles. In our previous review on the out of Africa, we dwell deeper into this scenario. See that video. And finally, third, they consider a scenario where Denisovans received gene flow from a hominin whose ancestor diverged deeply from the lineage leading to the Neanderthals, Denisovans and present-day humans. The researchers find that this scenario is consistent with the data and estimates that up to 8% of the Denisovan genome comes from an unknown hominin which split from other hominins between 1.1 and 4 million years ago. The putative admixture into the Denisovans from this unknown archaic group raises the possibility that the apparent Denisovan contribution to genomes of Papuans and Australians could originate from an admixture with the same unknown archaic population, instead of with Denisovans. They tested that hypothesis and found that the archaic component in the genomes of people in Papua New Guinea and Australia comes from a group related to the Denisovans and not from an unknown archaic hominin. Okay, so to our second question. Was there gene flow from early modern humans into Neanderthals? In the paper Ancient Gene Flow from Early Modern Humans into Eastern Neanderthals in Nature have investigated this. It has been shown that Neanderthals contributed genetically to modern humans outside of Africa about 47 to 65,000 years ago. Here the researchers analyzed the genomes of Neanderthals and Denisovans from the Altai Mountains in Siberia, together with sequences of chromosome 21 of two Neanderthals from Spain and Croatia. They find that the population that diverged from other modern humans in Africa contributed genetically to the ancestors of Neanderthals from the Altai Mountains, roughly 100,000 years ago. By contrast, they do not detect such genetic contributions in the Denisovans or the two European Neanderthals, concluding that in addition to later inbreeding events, the ancestors of Neanderthals from the Altai Mountains and early modern humans met and interbred, possibly in the Near East, many thousands of years earlier than the previously thought. We know that in modern humans, some Neanderthal genes have been positively selected for. Do we see similar indications in the Altai Neanderthal for young human DNA? To shed light on possible functional selection, they identified several putatively integrated segments, the longest one overlapping with the region suspected to have been under positive selection in modern humans. This region has a transcription factor gene involved in liver development, and one segment is located within the FOXP2 gene, which encodes a transcription factor that may be relevant for language acquisition. The integrated demographic analysis of multiple archaic and present-day human genomes suggest a scenario of long-term decline in populations of the Neanderthals and Denisovan, with a consistently small Altai Neanderthal population perhaps reflecting a long period of isolation in the Altai Mountains. In addition, there is evidence for modern human integration into the ancestor of this population of Neanderthals, and no such evidence in the European Neanderthals. These modern humans may have presented a population that diverged early from other modern humans in Africa and later met ancestors of the Altai Neanderthal, as mentioned in our earlier Out of Africa video. The finding of African haplotypes as young as 100,000 years old in the Altai Neanderthal genome is consistent with inbreeding around that age. The presence of modern humans in the Levant as early as 120,000 years ago, in addition to the recent demonstration that modern humans may have been in China as early as 120,000 years ago, also suggests that modern humans migrated early out of Africa. Thus, early modern humans may have had the opportunity to admix with archaic hominins before the main Out of Africa event around 60,000 years ago. That is all for today. Thank you for listening. Until next time, I wish you all the best.